would like to engage the participant in conversation. So one way we thought it to spark up a conversation is, can you just go to the internet, you can go to these various links. Okay. Later on, I'll show you a video. You can go to all these links. Or actually, the simulations are all inside here. Okay. I think some of you are already open. So maybe you can take 1 minute to explore it, and then as we go around, you can ask some of us who are walking around.
I think some of you are curious, okay, how long does it take to develop this particular applet? It really depends. Because from NTNU website, you can actually download the source code. So if there is already an existing one, you will just need to do modification. I think the beauty about easy Java simulation is that you can actually design the applet to your needs. If you have a particular way of designing it, you can actually design it. Okay, but of course, if you want to redesign the client interface, yeah. Okay, so in addition, so he may have experienced it, he may have seen it, so does he know? So the way we figured that the student can learn better is now, the student can now key in the values here. Okay, so for example, if you doubt me for a while, after this colline, if this is perfectly elastic, this number here should be something. Okay, so let's say the student is guessing 3. Okay, there is actually a feedback followed by a color. So it's red, you say that it's wrong, and the number is negative 3. So it's out by negative 3. So he has to keep on. So once he gets the right answer, we give affirmation of his effort. So we say yes, not C-O-M, and this is the formula that makes them understand the symbols.
Sorry, I'm just thinking, if I'm a visual student, I'm looking a lot at the simulation, right? Then it doesn't go with my mental model of if the green card is going to bang onto the yellow card should go out of the bench. I know you have a limitation of a space. Can you make the yellow card, the moment it leaves at the edge of the yellow bench, right? I mean the blue bench, can you make it fly in the air out of the screen rather than stopping there? Otherwise, I mean if I'm not a bright student, I would say, okay, after the elastic condition, the end result is somebody will stop. Then I will walk away with a kind of misconception.
But I think that is the limitation of simulation. That's the reason why not all
the... That's the reason why, okay, then maybe you have to have a disclaimer before the beginning of your playing. Because I will walk away with this if you don't tell me, if I'm a learner. Because my knowledge comes from playing with this and what you're telling me.
So one point to bring in is, if you're afraid of misconception that can be introduced by simulation, which is perfectly valid, one approach that we should look at is the call for blended learning, which is what Charles is advocating also. I think it's perfectly sound, because you get the student to do the actual setup, which we did in River Valley. The student actually saw something physical. But after that, we show some demo and all that, and then the student can see, okay, if this card drop off, it really was all up, but it's not in the simulation, you know, you can figure it out, why is it like that? Okay. So to tie in later on, the student will do one-to-one or pair group, then they do this experiment through the simulation. So they can see the bridge between the real setup and the simulation. So hopefully that can sort of address some of the misconceptions that the student may have after playing with the simulation alone without actually real life experience.
So after simulation, sometimes when the kids are not very clear, to them it's something that's very ideal, they walk away with the ideal case. So the question has been inserted in your humor in such a way that you can ask them to compare contrast of what is the reality, what is the model telling them, so how do they find the difference in the reality and explain the difference in what they are seeing on the model and their view case. That could be some kind of more reflective learning.
I was thinking that could be an extension question. So at the end of the whole thing, why do
it's a lot kind other questions?
Why do you think it happened this way?
And I think to address Yuri's point, of course it's good always to go for concrete, the real one, to the simulation. But this is still okay in the sense that you have a slightly longer RAM, but say t equals 0, okay, the collision, put in the t equals 0. Then after a certain point, you can say t equals to say t1. This is only a snapshot at t equals t1. And there's actually dot dot dot, there's still moving on. I think that will help to
explicitly
stated. So as you say, it's a photographic shot. Then you freeze the frame, right? all the hotels.
So you can actually get a student to play with it, they can explore, and then they can figure out, they can become my scientists essentially. They can come up with their own hypothesis, test it on the plan. And if they are good enough or so good to be Nobel laureate winners, they can right click on it, look at the source code, the way it was built, and then change it, and then come up with a better physics model. I'm perfectly agreeable to allow our student to be Nobel Prize winners.
Can you just say,
demonstrate,
right click and see the source code?
Okay, because we didn't install EGS here, so I'm not sure whether it will work. Yeah. Okay, so it's like this, right click, open EGS model. Okay, these physics professors have done it all. Okay, they know all the problems that school face, they made it. EGS is not found. Okay, so if you have EGS installed, which is very easy, just go to the website and download it. Run it once, and then forever you remember.